Hi, first grade. We're back for another math lesson. And for today's math lesson, you will need your baggie of cubes, your math work mat number 6, which is your number bond, and then your counting tape. Okay. And today's math lesson is going to be about real world addition problems. So it's going to be very similar to what we did the last time that we did story problems with addition, but now we're just talking more about real world problems, and you're going to see there's going to be more writing because when we have some of those real world problems, they write it out more, and we're going to have to kind of pull out that information, and I'll explain how to do that. And then next week, we will actually switch into working with subtraction, and we'll talk all about subtraction, what it means to subtract, how we subtract, and all of that next week. So first things first, I'm going to share my screen. Let's go through a couple of these pages, and then we will do some activities together before I explain your assignment today. So here we go. This is real world problems addition. And our learning objectives for today, it says write addition sentences related to real world problems, solve real world problems involving addition. And then over here, it says think. Addison has 3 fish tanks. She has 2 blue fish in each tank. She also has 1 orange fish in 2 of the tanks. How many fish does Addison have in all? Well, let's think about this. What's one really easy way that we could, you know, figure out how many she has in all? What do you think? What can we use that's on this page right now? Very good, the picture, right? We can just look at the picture and we can count how many fish there are, right? And if we do that, we see, first off, here's the 2 blue fish in this tank and the 1 orange fish. Then over here, we see our 2 blue and 1 orange. Let's count them together. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there we go. We see that she has 6 fish in all. Another way that we could do this is we could count on, right? So if we looked at this fish tank and we said, well, we see there are 3 fish, we can count on from 3, right? So if we were here, we would say 3, 4, 5, 6, right? And then counting on, you know, starting at 3 and then just counting on. For this one, we weren't taking a look necessarily at greater number or the smaller number, right? Or lesser number, because they're both the same number. So for that one, we could just start at 1 and count on adding on those other 3 fish. Okay. Let's go ahead and take a look at this next page. Let's learn a little bit about how we are planning to solve real-world problems involving addition. Right here, this is an example of what these real-world problems are going to look like. There are going to be 2 statements and then a question. That question is going to give you information on how you're supposed to solve it. Right now, we know that we're solving addition problems, but when we get into talking about subtraction and, you know, kind of mixing those 2 in with each other, looking at some important words, you know, at the end or in that question, that's going to be really, really important for us to determine whether it's an addition or a subtraction problem that we are going to have to solve. So right here it says, there are 6 chickens on a farm. There are 3 ducks on the same farm. How many animals are there in all? Well, when we see it say in all, that's telling us, okay, well, they want to know how many animals there are in all. They gave us 2 parts. They want us to join or add those 2 parts together and figure out the whole. So we know it's an addition problem. And the terminology at the end, in all, also tells us that too. So the steps when we're talking about real world addition problems or real world problems in general, these ones just involve addition. Number 1 is understand the problem. So it says, how many chickens are there? How many ducks are there? What do I need to find? Those are some questions that we have to ask. So how many chickens are there? Let's answer that question. Very good. There are 6. You could figure that out in 2 ways. Number 1, you could just go back to what it talked about in that initial story problem. And number 2, you can count the amount of chickens that are in the picture. How many ducks are there? Same thing you can do. Let's go back to that initial problem. There are 3 ducks. We know that there are 6 chickens. There are 3 ducks. And what do I need to find? That's that last question. Remember that last question says, how many animals are there in all? That's what we are trying to find. Next thing we have to do, step two, is think of a plan. And their plan said, I can use number buns to help me add. So let's do that. Let's get our number bun out. Let's have our cubes ready to go. And then step three is actually carrying out the plan. So it says carry out the plan. Well, we have our part, one of our parts is six. So let's go ahead and put six cubes in our part, one of our part circles on our number bond, and the other part is three for the six chickens and the three ducks. So let's go ahead and put six cubes in our one part section of our number bond and three cubes in our other part section of our number bond. And I will do that too. So you do that on yours and I will do that on mine. So here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three. Awesome. Now we know when we have our two parts, but we're missing our whole, all we have to do is pick a strategy and solve it, right? So think about all those strategies we talked about. Using our brain, using the picture, using our counting tape, counting on. So the strategy that I'm going to pick for us, let's do counting tape since I already had you guys get it out. So let's go ahead and grab our counting tape. Remember when we're using our counting tape or counting on, we are going to start at the greater number. What's the greater number out of six and three? Very good, six. So we're going to start at the number six and count on three times. Here we go. 7, 8, 9. Awesome. So you'll see that when we start at six and count on three times, or we do 6 plus 3, we get to the whole of 9. 9 is our whole. So go ahead, put 9 cubes now into your whole section of your number box. All right, and I'm going to write these numbers out just so that we have them up here. We have 6, 3, and 9, okay? And I'll show a little closer. There's 6 at the top, 3 at the bottom, and then 9 over there, part, part, whole. Then the last thing they did, they just wrote out an addition number sentence right here. They wrote 6 plus 3 equals 9. We also know that we could do that turnaround fact, which would be 3 plus 6 equals 9, right? And remember again, you write what you say. So if I say 6, I write 6 plus 3 equals 9. Good, and that plus sign stands for plus, and that equal sign stands for equals. All right, and then the very last step, which is step 4, says, check the answer. I can use cubes to help me check my answer. So they used cubes, but maybe then you would just go ahead and count your cubes in your number bun. Maybe then you would draw a picture or use the picture. So when you're going to check your work, you use a strategy that's different from what you use to solve it to go ahead and check your work. If you have cubes or if you want to use our cubes and set it up like they did, you could do that too. And then they went and they said 6, 7, 8, 9. They were able to check their work and, you know, make sure and clarify and make sure that, you know, that whole is actually 9 so that we solve the problem right. Okay, let's go ahead and do the next. Let's talk about the next problem and then we'll do the next problem together. And then we may do another one together or I might just show you your assignment. We'll see how we're feeling when we get to that point, okay? So go ahead, clear your board. This one we're just going to talk about and then we'll do this one together, okay? And this one is when we're going to actually use that 4-step process. So it says, Jayla has 4 paper planes. She makes 5 more paper planes. How many paper planes does Jayla have now? So again, we have to start with step one. Step one is understanding the problem. Well, how many paper planes does she have to start with? Good, she has 4, right? And you can see that they put 4 in one of the part sections of the number bond, and here are the 4 paper planes. How many more does she make? Very good, she makes 5 more. So 5 over here, and then 5 in that one part section of the other part section of the number bond. And then what are they asking us to do? Or what is the question? What do they want us to solve? how many paper planes does Jayla have now? Good. So they're asking us to join those two groups, right? Or join those two parts to figure out our whole. So our two parts are 4 and 5. Step 2 is making a plan, right? So now we have to make a plan. So what's a possible plan? How could we solve this? How could we solve this? Or how did they actually solve it? Yeah, we could use our number bond again, right? We're not going to do it right now, but we're kind of talking through and then we'll do the next one together, okay? So good, we could use the number bond. And then you know that we have 4 and 5 in our two-part sections. Then we have to pick a strategy to solve for us when we join together or add our two parts to get our whole. So you'd pick a strategy and maybe your strategy this time would be the picture. Let's use the picture. So if we have 4 over here, let's go ahead and count 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then over here, we would put 9, right? So after then, and we kind of did it without talking about it, the first part is understanding the problem, right? Step 1. Step 2 is making that plan. Step 3 is carrying out that plan. So when we then go and actually start solving it, we're carrying out that plan. And then step 4 would be checking our answer. So we figured out that there are 9 over here. Maybe we check our answer by using our counting tape. And we'd start at that greater number, which is 5, and then count on 4 times. Here we go. 6, 7, 8, 9. We see we land on the number 9. So we can then say, yes, we are absolutely right. 9 is our answer. So Jayla has 9 paper planes now, okay? All right, let's go ahead and do the next problem together, and then I will explain your assignment for today, which goes along with what we're doing, okay? Down here it says solve, okay? And it's going to tell us some information. So it says there are 2 bluefish in a tank. There are also 4 orange fish in the same tank. How many fish are there in all? And we see our little fox is telling us, use the 4-step problem-solving model to help you, okay? So I will do it on my board and I'll bring you guys closer. I want to keep this up just so that we can see it. And you can also do it on your number bond with me too, okay? As I'm clearing this off, who can think about what step 1 is? What's that first step in the problem solving model? Very good. Understanding the problem. So in order to understand the problem, you have to figure out, what did the problem tell you? What information did they give us in that problem that will help us out with solving it? So let's go ahead and take a look right here and let's think about how many fish there are, because that's going to really help us out right now with solving it, okay? So it says there are 2 blue fish in a tank. Let's go ahead and put 2 cubes in one part section of our number bond. Go ahead and do that now. While you do that, I'm going to do that too. Nice job. Then it says there are also 4 orange fish in the same tank. There's our other part, so let's put 4 cubes in our other part section of our number bond. Good. And now we have to figure out, what is the problem asking us? What does the problem want us to do? Well, it says, how many fish are there in all? So we hear those in all, right? Those 2 words, in all, and we know that's telling us to join together or add together our 2 parts to find our whole. So that second part then is making a plan, right? So we understand the problem now. We understand that our 2 parts are 2 and 4 and that we need to add those 2 parts together. Now we need to make a plan. So we need to make a plan to solve. What can we use? What are we already kind of using? Good, our number bond. So our number bond is going to be involved in pretty much all these problems that we do. And then we pick a strategy to solve. What strategy should we pick to solve? How about this time we just count? Let's just count what we have in our number bond and see what we get, okay? So that would be planning it out. And then step 3 is actually what? Good, carrying out the plan. So here's what I want you to do with me. We're going to go ahead and count what we have in our 2-part sections of our number bond. So here we go. Let's count together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's go ahead and put 6 cubes in our whole section of our number bond. 6 cubes in our whole section of our number bond. Okay. Now, we carried our plan out, but we're not done yet. Let's check our work first to make sure that we carried our plan out correctly. And let's go ahead and check our work with fingers. Let's use fingers this time. Why not? So let's go ahead and put up two fingers and four fingers. And you can put them down as you count. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Very good. So we'd see that 2 and 4, when added together, make 6, or 2 plus 4 equals 6. Now, if you were actually doing this on your page, and you will be doing this in just a moment, you know there's a couple things that you have to do first, right? First things first, complete your number bond, because once your number bond is completed and filled in, you have all the information that you need to solve the rest of it. So first thing you'd want to do is write 6 in your whole section of your number bond, because we just figured out that 6 is our whole. Then you have everything that you need to fill in the rest of it, right? And for this part right here, remember that it's part plus part equals whole. It does not matter which part you list first for this. They're only asking you for one addition number sentence. So you could put either 2 plus 4 equals 6, or you could either put, what would be that turnaround fact? Good, 4 plus 2 equals 6. We know that after the equal sign is our whole, so that's not changing, but we can go ahead and make that turnaround fact and flip the order of our two parts, because it's the same amount that we're joining together when we're adding those two numbers. And then down here it says there are blank fish in all. This is where our whole goes, okay? All right, let's take a look at our assignment for today. It goes along with what we just did. So it says real world addition problems, and this is in your math workbook, pages 35 and 36. And you see right here, they don't have a number bond written out for you. So this would be where you can use your number bond, or use what strategy you think best fits for you, or what way best fits for you based on what the problem is asking and how you kind of feel. We talked about last week finding a strategy that works best for you, and using that number bond is actually, you know, a strategy to help you out with planning out your thinking and moving things around, but we'll use it a lot to kind of lay out what we have. So if you want to use it, make sure you use your number bond in your cubes, okay? But how this works, you have to go through those four steps, right? Understand the problem, create a plan, carry out the plan, check your work, okay? So right here, you may need some help reading these, which is totally fine. Ask whoever's at home with you to go ahead and help you out with reading these. But it says, Matthew has 4 t-shirts. He receives 2 t-shirts as presents. How many t-shirts does Matthew have in all? Okay, so that's where you're pulling those two parts from. Here's the other thing that's really important, is they don't have anything in this circle, but we know what goes in that circle for our addition problems, right? What goes in that circle? What sign? Very good, the plus sign. So don't forget to put your plus sign in that circle, okay? Then you'd move to number 2, where it talks about Malia having a certain number of hair bands, and you'll go ahead and read through that and then carry out a plan, right? So once you understand the problem, you're going to figure out how you want to solve it, okay? And then you'll go ahead and solve that problem, adding the two parts together and figuring out what your whole is and writing that all out right here. Then the last two problems are just like the first two, but just obviously different things going on. So this is talking about Henry folding paper fish. So again, figuring out what your two parts are and what the problem is asking of you. And remember, we're adding in all of these. We've not done subtraction yet, so we're adding in all of these. Making sure you fill in everything you need to fill in. And then down here, same exact thing, but talking about Miss Black ironing some dresses, okay? Now here's a couple things I will say. If you wanna draw out number bonds and write in your numbers because that helps you, either do it somewhere on this page or use a white piece of paper. You can use a white piece of paper and just draw out your number bonds to help you, or you can use your work mat number 6 and help you out and fill them in, but if it makes it easier for you to write things out, you can do that. Another way you can do it too is by filling out, you know, filling your cubes in this number bond and then drawing another number bond on your dry erase board and actually writing those numbers in, okay? So again, you're finding the way that works best for you to solve. Make sure that you, you know, are reading these to figure out, because that's where you're going to find the information you need, okay? Or get someone at home to help you read them. And then use that picture too. That picture is there for you, so you might as well use it, okay? All right, then after you guys finish that, you'll take a picture of it, post it directly onto Class Dojo Portfolio, and I look forward to seeing your awesome work that you guys do. We'll continue working with addition as well, but also move into working with some subtraction next week. So be ready for that, okay? All right, nice job, and I hope you have a great rest of your day. Bye, first grade.